Best to keep it neutral, got my own religion. The brainwashed, gotta make your own decision. My word is James Bond, I stay on the mission. Coming for the top position, ain't no competition, man. Pull up in the top, it's missing, f*** the opposition, man. All that lane switching, this is what the game is. It's the young, incredible, honestly unforgettable. You a joke like Chappelle Show, this so perennial. Do this for my millennials, I be murdering any flow. I just had to let you know. It's the young, incredible, honestly unforgettable. You a joke like Chappelle Show, this so perennial. Do this for my millennials, I be murdering any flow. I just had to let you know.
My name, huh?
You ready?
S-T-R-O, I ain't come to play with you.
Yeah.
Life challenging, but I wouldn't trade with you.
Trade.
It's early, I'm up.
Yeah.
I can't spend the day with you. I'm minding my business. I ain't getting paid with you.
No,
my color bright.
Yeah.
I ain't finna fade with you. Man, I gotta come clean like
I
made with you. I've been on my everybody drop when I drop.
Yeah.
This shorty, she support, bruh. Lifting up. Never not on my grind. New York City time. Another brother better, you will never find. I've been in my bag like groceries. Competition shouldn't take shots, take notes, please.
Yeah, yeah.
Reporting live from the winner's side. Ready to try, keep a different vibe. Is you down the ride, never tired. You will never know, you ain't never tried. Work it out, hit the gym, hit the field.
Yeah,
hey, yo, I need that. Big chips, man, I need that. Hustle hard, on the job, you can see that. On my head is real good.
EA Sports coverage of the NFL brings us to the heart of Texas and the very wonderful AT&T Stadium in Arlington. A moment ago, here was the scene with the Cowboys emerging from their tunnel. It was loud. It's still loud. We're ready for football as the Cowboys get set to match up with the New England Patriots. There's Mike Nugent now to put this one in the air. And we are underway from AT&T Stadium. Short boot, take it at the 21. And they're going to have really good starting field position here as that's taken up close to the 40. So from the 39 now, they'll come up on a first and 10.
You better bring
Here's the first carry for Ezekiel Elliott. 4 yards the result on the first play from scrimmage. Second down.
When we see those runs to the perimeter, when we see those runs to the edge, we think about big breakers, don't we? In this case, it was a modest gain, but it does open up possibilities here on second down.
The run got 4. Now they deal with a 2nd and 6.
Set the tone, defense. Who's up 40?
Here's Prescott. Completes it to Jason Witten. And he's got another first down as the tackle's going to be made at the Patriots 37.
I do believe we'll see a little bit more of this as this game progresses, because when you can have that type of a game in the middle of the defense, it hurts them in so many ways, because most teams like to be strong down the middle. And if you can sting them there, that opened things up for you on the outside as well.
That's where he, their big tight end, is so good. That middle third, the seam routes, the end routes. Yeah, you're right. Probably see more of that.
Yeah, it takes a lot of courage and fortitude to go in the middle as well. And he's got it.
On 2nd down, Elliott. And they'll be inside the 35 now at the 34-yard line.
One thing to keep in mind, partner, especially in the second half, when you've got a running back of this size, of these dimensions, I can just tell you, attrition does set in for a defense, because you're excited about hitting him in the first half. Maybe not so much in the second half, and some of these shorter gains turn into bigger runs later.
to throw is Prescott. And he's able to hook up with Michael Gallup. And he gets this one inside the 15, just a yard or two shy of the 10. And they're able to convert on third with a solid gain of 23.
Here we go, G, get off the field.
A first down carry by Elliott. And he'll take it into the end zone for a Cowboy touchdown. Taking it in from 11 yards out. And they are able to strike first here on their opening drive. And they do exactly what they wanted to. Opening drive, they get into the end zone. They do it on the ground.
And not only is the person lugging the ball happy, of course, because he got it into the end zone. How about the offensive linemen and receivers who are blocking for him? They have to feel great about themselves sticking in the end zone on a running play.
And that'll carry over the back line of the end zone for a touchback. So Brady and the Pats take over first and 10 at their own 25-yard line. Working from the gun, it's Brady. And it's hauled in by Ben Watson. And they work this well upfield across the 45. 23 yards on the play.
Defense gives up a touchdown on the opening drive. Offense, you got to want to get out there and get those points back right now.
And that's a sharp throw there to get this drive off to a good start. So one play, and they're already just shy of midfield. Shotgun now for Brady. And he's going to go down. They sack him back at the 42. Defensive end DeMarcus Lawrence applied the heat. Great job defensively. I think he was trying to go through his progressions, find someone to get rid of the football. Before he knew it, he was on his back.
So that just brings us right back to what you said in the beginning. A great job defensively. Nowhere to go with the football. That led to the sack.
To try again after the sack, Brady. And he's going to be stopped up right at the line of scrimmage. All in all, no gain on the play, and it'll bring up third.
Well, the defensive guys won't be real happy because there won't be a sack on this play because he did get back to the line of scrimmage. But what a job they did overall. Hemmed him in and gave him nowhere to go with the football.
Wait, 10, wait, 20, minus 54, 72. Screen, what's the screen?
On third and long, it's Brady. And that's complete. It's Watson. And he's going to be brought down on what will be the final play of this first quarter. After one, 7-0 on EA Sports. So here's a first and 10 at the 38. On the toss, here's Michelle. Anthony Brown there on the tackle. The run only got a yard. Here's second and 9. They'll run it. This is Michelle. They follow up the first down 1 yard run with a minimal gain of 2.
Partner, we know today's NFL is really built around the guy throwing the football. But these short runs, they still pay dividends because they can take their toll on a defense and they can add up as the game goes along. You control the clock, you control the ball, and that way you often control the game.
48 mark.
Throwing is Brady on third down. He's got Sanu. And he's able to pick up the first before he's taken down at the 27. And they just keep marching right along. First down on a pickup of 8 there. Throwing on first down is Brady. This is White on the screen. And inside the 20 before he's brought down. A 10-yard pickup, and it's enough for a Patriot first down.
when you run a screen pass really well, you got to like the look of it because so many parts come together to make it work well. The offensive linemen where they're faking people out, the back slipping out there, catching the football, then all of them going together as one unit downfield, a really nice pickup.
Into the red zone, it's Brady. And that's going to be incomplete. Too tough to hold on to that one. It's second down.
Chance is good. He's going to be a very busy guy. Two catches already in this opening drive, and they were looking his way for a third.
I think they put this defense on notice that that could be a really, really frequent combination. Brady's incompletion on first down leads to a second and 10. Throwing again. Brady. Being chased out left. It's just a gain of a couple there on the scramble, and now it's third down.
You got it. You got it. 2 yard gain on the play. And it's third down.
In search of 8 yards on third down. They've already converted two of these on this drive, 2 for 2. Brady. And this is caught. It's Edelman. And stopped a few yards shy of the goal line at the 3. Coming up at halftime in a little less than 2 minutes, we'll send you to Orlando where Jonathan Coachman is standing by. He'll have highlights in and out. And he's over the line and into the end zone for a Patriots score. A 3-yard touchdown run as they are now on the board here in the first half. Solid job up front. Really just a solid job all the way around to get that one in.
That was well executed, wasn't it? Well blocked, well run. End result, 6 points.
Touchdown. Nugent tacking on the PAT, and we are tied at 7. Each team's had it. Each team has scored. 7-7 here as the kick's away. This is fielded at the chalk of the 10. And a good effort on the return there. Gets him across the 30 to the 33-yard line. The Dallas offense here set to begin the drive. And they had to wait a long time to get the football back. Probably not what you were hoping for when you got an offensive helmet.
Agreed. What you were looking for is the defense get the ball back pretty quickly, right? Hoping for a 3-and-out. So that didn't happen. You can't yell at your D for that. They've got to take care of their own business and reestablish themselves now that they're back on the field.
On second down, it's Elliott. He's got the first down and more past midfield. And he is into the end zone for a Cowboy touchdown. Ezekiel Elliott with his second touchdown here in this first half. And the Cowboys have taken the lead. And always a good first half when you can hit pay dirt twice.
And it never hurts to have that good feeling as the game moves on. Just think about halftime. If that's all he gets, he'll just sit there at the half and think, all right, 2 already. I can get some more. I can get some more. And he'll be encouraging his offensive line to create some space.
This will be taken in at the 1. And he'll get across the 20 before he's brought down at about the 23-yard line. The Pats at the line, ready to go. It was still more than a minute to go in the half. Time to try to mount a drive.
And I would think that they would have to. This is today's NFL. You got to push it whenever you get an opportunity. You can never have enough points with the high-powered offenses that you face. And analytics will tell you, try and score when given the opportunity.
Brady now to throw. Caught by Sanu. And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory. Now the Patriots going to use one of their timeouts as the clock's going to stop with 47 seconds to go in half number 1. Back-to-back good plays have him on the move on first down. Movement there on the offensive line, a little quick, and a 5-yard penalty. And that'll set him back 5.
You ain't got nothing. You ain't got nothing. Wait, 20.
From the gun, it's Brady. And this one brought in by Sanu. And he's corralled, but not before getting it inside the 35. Now the Patriots will use the second of their timeouts as they'll stop it with 40 seconds remaining in this first half. So they'll come up first and 10 now from the 33. Brady to throw again. Nowhere to escape, and he goes down. DeMarcus Lawrence able to get in there for his second sack of the afternoon. After the sack on first down, Brady complete to Dorsett. And all the way inside the 15 before they drop it. The Patriots will take their third and final timeout as they stop it with 11 seconds remaining in this first half. Brady now nearly perfect. 9 of 10 in this first half. It's first and 10. Inside the red zone here. They'll look to throw. He's got Lacoste, his tight end. And he'll be taken down at the 2-yard line. 11 more yards that go around, a first down as well. So we've hit intermission. It's halftime. This is the NFL, and it's a presentation of EA Sports. Both teams appear ready for the fight ahead, and we resume action here in quarter number 3. This is fielded at the goal line. And an excellent return there as he's up to the 35 and make it the 40-yard line.
That strong return has set them up nicely for this drive, and we all know the next score is going to have a major impact on this game.
The Pats at the line, ready to go. They're close, close game, but they're going to need to do a little bit better probably here in half two, no?
I would agree with that totally. I would guess it in the locker room. They talked about cleaning up some of the errors, but overall, I think they wanted to be positive with them. Guys, we're right there, just not playing as well as we need to. Let's pick it up, and we still have a chance to win this game.
Yeah, they do. We'll see if they can pick it up. Looking to throw on second down. Brady. And he fires one that's intercepted. Picked up by Leighton Vander Esch. And they'll set up shop right near midfield at the 49-yard line.
Well, this is a defense that can confuse even the best of quarterbacks with their zone schemes. And here you've got a linebacker that's going to stay at home and just sit down in that zone. And this one basically comes right to him.
Following the interception, here's Prescott. Now they go screen, it's complete. And they'll get him down as he's inside the 40. 11 yards and a Cowboy first down.
They ran that one well, and not only did they pick up a nice chunk of yardage on the screen, they sent a message to the defense. Rush the passer all you want, but you better be careful. We can hit you going back the other direction.
On the RPO, Prescott's going to keep it himself. Looking for his running back, and he's got him. Give him 7 on the play, and it'll be a second down.
And we see another pitch and catch there to the running back. This position just continues to evolve. They become just as critical to the passing attack as a lot of receivers, tight ends, because their ability to make people miss in the open field can really generate big plays for an offense.
Throwing on 2nd and 3, Prescott. And he goes down. It's a Patriots sack.
Got to give him points for the attempt, but there's just a wave of pressure there. A host of people in the area. Evades a few, but couldn't evade all of them.
They'll need a big play here. Will Dak and the Cowboys after the sack. It's third and long. From the shotgun, it's Prescott. Cooper's got it. And they'll wind up getting this one all the way down inside the 20. A good pickup there, 26 yards. So Amari Cooper out of Northwestern High School in Miami making a nice play there.
And it's so funny that when I was going through the draft process when he came out of Alabama and was inquiring about him and his skills, they say it all began back in Miami. He really became a pro receiver at a young age because of his attention to detail and precision.
And he'll take it into the end zone for a Cowboy touchdown. Scampering home from 19 yards out. And the Cowboys, they push out in front further. Always important to get the first score of the second half. Now you start to pull away a little bit and get some breathing room going.
And now we find out about the fortitude of the group that's behind, because they were counting on getting into the game a little bit more, right? Maybe they get the first score. That doesn't happen. It looks almost insurmountable, but it's not. Let's see how hard they play the rest of the game.
This is fielded at the goal line. And his guys will get the football right at the 20-yard line. The Pats at the line, ready to go. And following the interception, just any interception, are you a little bit more cautious when you start that next drive, or no, you just throw that out the window?
I think you are. I don't think that there's any way you can run back out there and go, totally didn't affect me. Let's just go ahead and be loose with the football again. You're going to take care of it, but you have to be careful about being too cautious, because now you can't run any offense at all.
Still want to attack. We'll see how they attack them here. Brady now on first down. And that is incomplete. He couldn't hold on through the contact. Brings up second down. You know, despite the scoreline, I think they've got to like where they are here. They're on the road and just one big play away from getting right back in this game.
I'm going to follow right along with you, because the spot they're in now is a credit to their defense. They've kept them in it by making the plays that they've made, and that just means you're one big score away from being right back there.
Now the question is, can this offense step up and make that play? Because that's been an issue for them in this game. 15 yards on the play, first down. Now Brady, and this will be incomplete. Physical play on the football there, and it's second down.
It is tough to complete pass against zone defenses. The windows that you see open, they shrink pretty rapidly. How about being able to hit a moving target against a zone before the next guy can get there and make a play on the ball?
Not easy for any quarterback, no matter the situation. And there, the defense won the battle. To throw once more on second and 10. Brady, and this one incomplete. Too much contact to hold on to that one, and it's third down. He was trying to go back to Edelman, and it's third down. Again, they'll throw with Brady. And oh, this is taken in one-handed. What a catch. And he gets this inside the 35-yard line. Brady, perfect since the second half started. 7 of 7. It's first and 10. He'll get 3 yards on the scramble there. It's second down. We have played three quarters. We'll return with more after this. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports. Second down, Brady. On the crossing route, that's caught. Julian Edelman. And he gets it all the way down inside the 10 and mark him at the 5. A first down there on a pickup of 25. They'll try and run for it on first and goal. And he will push his way forward down to about the 3-yard line. Only a yard on the pickup there. Second and goal.
Every team we ever talk to that continues to run the ball in a game, even when they haven't had much success, all talks about attrition, don't they? If you keep running it, eventually good things are likely to happen. It's been a hard go in this game today, hasn't it?
Yeah, this defense, they met pretty much every challenge in front of them this afternoon.
They're still trying to run the ball, but they're not finding much space.
And he'll get nothing out of that one. Nothing on the screen that time. Now it's third down.
I thought that wasn't a bad time to call the screen. I thought late game, down on the scoreboard, had to figure they were expecting a pass downfield.
Yeah, so the edge rushers, they're coming. That could have hit big. You're right. Good recognition defensively to snuff that one out. Brady going to throw. And he's going to go down just outside of the five, right around the six-yard line. Antoine Woods drops him for a four-yard loss there, and that brings up fourth down. The field goal doesn't help. They're going to go for the six here on fourth and goal. Brady to throw for it on fourth down. The quick slant caught. He's going to be stopped shy of the end zone. They get the... Completion, but cannot push forward into the end zone, and it'll be a turnover on downs. About set for this next drive by the Cowboys offense. The ledger for them so far looks pretty good, doesn't it?
It certainly does. Touchdown, touchdown, touchdown. Not sure it can be much better than that. They've got to feel very good about the groove that they're in at this stage of the game.
9 yards is the pickup there, and they'll have a second and one. The last run got nine. That leaves them with second and a yard. They go to Elliott again. And he's going to have to protect the football and take his lumps here at this stage of the game as they stop him behind the line. So the Cowboys in possession of the football here as we get you reset. They've got a third down now as they look for one more first down to help salt this one away. And intercepted. Maybe the turning point they need. Picked off at the 22. And his guys are going to take over at the 21-yard line. Two-score game here in the fourth, and that pick, it kind of keeps the door ajar, doesn't it?
It does, and you wonder about their strategy because with a two-score lead, you think maybe you're just sitting on and trying to drain some clock. It's almost like they felt like, hey, we've got a good cushion. We can keep pressing it. It ended up costing them.
And they work this near the five. He'll be stopped at the six. That gain of 15 gets him on the doorstep, first and goal. Here's Brady to throw. As a man, and it's Edelman for the Patriot touchdown. It's a six-yard touchdown pass as his guys are back within a single score. Okay, game on. Don't go anywhere yet. You got a one-score game now. Probably going to rely on the onside kick coming up.
Yeah, they have to. It's not a high percentage play, but it's better than not having a chance at all. And that's when you put your leapers and your flyers on one side, get that high hop, and hope that one of the guys can come up with it.
And on the other side, get that hands team ready.
No doubt about it.
And this one travels out of bounds. So unsuccessful there on the onside kick try. The Dallas offense here set to begin the drive. And this game not quite over yet. And we'll likely see them take all three timeouts defensively, so they can't just kneel this one out. They're going to have to try to run a few plays.
You're exactly right. They've got to get a first down and make them use up all their timeouts in order to feel like they have this one in hand.
I have to chuckle to myself a little bit, Brandon, because right now I can be in that huddle with that offensive line. I know exactly what they're saying. If you call a pass play here, we're going to call a timeout. Run the football. We've got control of this thing. Get in behind us and let's go.
Their time to shine. Now the Patriots will use the second of their timeouts as they'll talk it over here before what will be an important third down. Now Prescott. He's got his target. It's Cobb. And they're able to work this to the 25 before it's all said and done. Call that a very strong gain of 24.
Never make the mistake that the slot receivers, especially the little guys like we're watching here, are just quicker than fast. A lot of them combine quickness and speed, and they catch a lot of footballs, as we just saw there.
Well, Prescott here to throw. He's going to go up top for the end zone. And look at this. They get the turnover they needed. It's intercepted. Picked off by Jason McCourty. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back. A critical error there in a tight game of the fourth.
All you talk about is taking care of the football, and especially with a lead here in the fourth quarter, turning it over, now the door is open for the opposition.
Just in general, when you're passing in the fourth quarter with a lead, no matter what point, you got to be super careful.
Got to be careful, and sometimes you can be so careful that you end up running yourself into an error.
23 yards, the final tally. That's what they need right now. Get the first down, get out of bounds, stop the clock.
Just playing smart football, understanding the situation, making the plays necessary, and making sure that clock stops at every opportunity.
To throw is Brady. And nowhere to fit that football in. It's knocked away and incomplete. The Notre Dame man, Jalen Smith, able to get a hand in and knock it away. Brady's incompletion on first down leads to a second and 10. Back to throw. His throw incomplete. Chidobe Awuzie there to make the play in coverage. This defense so strong all afternoon long. Well executed again there.
This is a group that really functions well off of each other. No matter what the assignment, the other person fills in the exact proper spot. They've made it very, very hard for them to find open places to throw the football.
That's back-to-back plays of over 20 yards. Brady to throw. Under pressure and down he goes. They sack him back at the 36. DeMarcus Lawrence able to disrupt yet another pass play. That is his third sack of the afternoon. Well, we saw a close game that kept us on the edge of our seats down to that final whistle. And right before that final whistle, defense with one last exclamation mark there getting the sack to end it.
I love how you phrased it because we were waiting to see what would happen. Obviously, we thought something would happen downfield. Instead, it happens in the offensive backfield, and that's your ball game.
That'll do it for us. For Charles Davis and all our hardworking crew, I'm Brandon Gauden. You've been watching the NFL on EA Sports. For more, find us on Twitter at EA Madden NFL. It's a win for the Cowboys as we sign off and say so long from Arlington.
Grind now. Game on, took a loss, but I stay strong. Super Bowl rings, I just wanna play off. Gotta go hard, I can never play soft. Giant in New York, I run it back like Saquon. And I gotta win no matter what, like fourth down, Hail Mary, no punch. Like every time I touch down, I gotta stunt. Randy Moss, yeah, my number's going up. All these trophies, what do I need any more for? Check the stats up, you can check the scoreboard. Check the stats, Jay Critch, I'm the QB. Ran it up and then I went and got a new freeze. How fit to be the boss? Let me find out. My team ballin', you look like you need a timeout. I'm a star, in the clutch, I'ma shine out. Working hard, yeah, I'm back on my grind now. Game on, took a loss, but I stay strong. Super Bowl rings, I just wanna play off. Gotta go hard, I can never play soft. Giant in New York, I run it back like Saquon. How fit to be the boss? Let me find out. My team ballin', you look like you need a timeout. I'm a star, in the clutch, I'ma shine out. Working hard, yeah, I'm back on my grind now. Game on, took a loss, but I stay strong. Super Bowl rings, I just wanna play off. Gotta go hard, I can never play soft. Giant in New York, I run it back like Saquon. If you ain't a winner, then don't come round. On my way to another city, it's a touchdown. Under late, yeah, I gotta get it in a rush now. Let them hate, try to knock me down, but we got up now. You say that you ballin', keep it real though. Why I never saw you in the field though? Hey, I make it look easy, it's a field goal. I've been grinding for a minute and I'm still going. How fit to be the boss? Let me find out. My team ballin', you look like you need a timeout. I'm a star, in the clutch, I'ma shine out. Working hard, yeah, I'm back on my grind now. Game on, took a loss, but I stay strong. Super Bowl rings, I just wanna play off. Gotta go hard, I can never play soft. Giant in New York, I run it back like Saquon. How fit to be the
my doubt. My team ballin', you look like you need a timeout. I'm a star, in the clutch, I'ma shine out. Working hard, yeah, I'm back on my grind now. Game on, took a loss, but I stay strong. Super Bowl rings, I just wanna play off. Gotta go hard, I can never play soft. Giant in New York, I run it back like Saquon.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. Hey, foreign cars, foreign foreign seats with the foreign leather. Foreign number, put the card in the ATM in the said era. Yeah, flex mode, this ain't Southwest, this a jet. I ain't gotta shut the cell off, cause the iPhone don't got a jet mode. Bad be presto. If you wanna come, let's go. We ain't going nowhere special. I just wanna see Modesto. Hit you throwing, I'ma catch those. Mexican, dummy pesos. Hit you sus, I'll replace those. Never save, no name though. Tell them we need more. Put numbers on the board, let them keep a score. Hey, 16 cars in my front yard. Hey, 30 on my wrist, bullet points of God. Big numbers, big numbers. 100-minute bag, that's a big number. Big numbers, big numbers. Whole team count it, that's a big number.
Yeah, wrist man, check the wrist man, got him hot. Hey. Man can't ball like this, man. Lord, pass the pig scan when he stretch a distance. I'm talking a few 100,000 yards. You just on your 5th grand. Run it up, 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 count it up. Hey, 100s and 50s and 20s, no fives and no singles, don't count on them. Hey, she wanted like me, cause I blame she can't count on him. She try to be nosy and hit up my ex. She like, girl, you can count on him.
Hey, hey, we need more, tell him we need more. Putting numbers on the board, let them keep the score. Hey, 16 cars in my front yard. Hey, 30 on my wrist, bullet points of God. Big numbers, big numbers. 100-minute bag, that's a big number. Big numbers, big numbers. Whole team counted, that's a big number. Big numbers, big numbers. 100-minute bag, that's a big number. Big numbers, blue punts. Whole team count, that's a big number.
It's lonely on top of the throne. I am a king of the pawn. Hop on a jet, cross the gold. I guess the world is my home, and there's so many milkers burning my dome, and like turbulent air, I'm switching these flows. If you look at my neck, boy, I'm letting it snow. I'm sturdy as hell, you're Sylvester Stallone. They showing me love in my city. Gangs ain't hippies. Women like Nicki know what I'm about. I'm not the stereotypes. They do not fit me. I'm bigger than life. Give everyone jaws. I'm not a guard, but heart with a squad. I'm playing my part, but I'm LeBron. Wings of the team, I feel Jackson at heart. The homie calling from a cell. A couple of homies be making it. I just want all of them dudes to do well. Not worried about taking a couple of L's. Don't sin for me, just win for me. Don't kill for me, just live for me. Keep it real for me. We eat together, leave the bill for me. Like,
hand on my heart, I give it all I got. Walk the walk inside the talk. Take it higher, that's a God. Hand on my heart, no, I give it all I got. Walk the walk, talk the talk. Take it higher, that's a God. Never stopping, that's a must. Always winning, never lost. GPS, I never lost. GPS, I never lost.
Who do it better than me, yeah? Vision of 2020, yeah. VVS, company, yeah. Determination, laser focus. Banging on they, on they. Though they taking notice, taking notice, taking notice. Determination, laser focus. Banging on they, on they. Though they taking notice.
The young, incredible, honestly unforgettable. You a joke like Chappelle Show. This so perennial. Do this for my millennials. I be murdering any flow. I just had to let you know. It's the young, incredible, honestly unforgettable. You a joke like Chappelle Show. This so perennial. Do this for my millennials. I be murdering any flow. Yeah. I just had to let you know. Yeah. Give me that work and I can sell it. I put it on the line like I ain't selfish, nah. The story flip if I let you tell it. Put my heart and soul in, so you feel it. I ain't never faking, I'm the realest. Tupac in imprisonment, claiming his innocence. Currently, I'm the greatest rapper in a sense. But any currency, I'm still guaranteed my wins. This is coming from within, I stuff for real, I don't pretend. When the OG spilling knowledge, bet it's best you soak it in. I'm a prophet to them scholars, got them chakras opening. Got them fixing up their actors, now they truly focused in, I'm seeing 2020 visions, daily manifesting on my premonitions. Best to keep it neutral, got my own religion. The brainwash, gotta make your own decision. My word is James Bond, I stay on the mission. Coming for the top position, ain't no competition, man. Pull up in the top, it's missing, fuck the opposition, man. All that lane switching, this is what the game missing. It's the young, incredible, honestly unforgettable. You a joke like Chappelle Show, this so perennial. Do this for my millennials, I be murdering any flow. I just had to let you know. It's the young, incredible, honestly unforgettable. You a joke like Chappelle Show, this so perennial. Do this for my millennials, I be murdering any flow. I just had to let you know. Get violent, ay, cause he gave me patience, ay, swear the don't make sense, ay, when you making bands can make friends, cause I know they tryna shit like Ray Bans, got a bad little shorty wasting, and I own it, I ain't gotta pay rent, ay, I know we the ones that ain't them, put both hands together and I'm saying amen, cause I'm going big, going big, everywhere I go they know the click. Too many wins, they know the shit. They was hating, know they sick. Acting like they know me, cause I'm going big, going big. Everywhere I go, they know the click. Way too many wins, they know the shit. They was hating, know they sick. Acting like they know me, cause I'm going big, going bigger. Postmates, how I deliver. My game too cold, made it shiver. But I'm still a hot boy, cool it down, let it simmer. Ayy, see him mad, got him bitter. Can't stop the shine with a dimmer. Only what I give her. And she let her call me baby, but I do not need a sitter. See me dip, yeah, I'm saucing. People at the bank see me often. Let the money run, it's a faucet. She gave me the that's a faucet. Took over the game, now we all in. I was down in the chips, then went all in. Throwing up the game, ain't no vomit. Make my mama stop working, that's the promise. Going big, going big. Everywhere I go, they know the click. Way too many wins, they know the shit. They was hating, know they sick. Acting like they know me, cause I'm going big, going big. Everywhere I go, they know the click. Way too many wins, they know the shit. They was hating, know they sick. Acting like they know me, cause I'm
P-P-P-Lo, time to bring the bass, bird.
I just ran a checkup on myself. Some days I just have to check up on myself. I'm so icy, got that GG on my belt. Thank the Lord for my people and my health. Lost a lot, but I came out with no L's. Thank the Lord for my people and my health. And I'm fine as hell from my head down to my nails. My man tripping cause I got another sale. He still buy me YSL. I could get it by myself. These I could get it by myself. I'ma get it by myself, yeah. Feel like Ginger from Casino. Aces up my sleeve, though. Right before I leave, I said like I'm Dino. Think I'm part Italian, blending on Gino. Snowflake the medallion, the skin on cappuccino. I don't kiss and tell, keep your distance from myself. Fettuccine with the snails in a five-star hotel. And
It's the NFL on EA Sports as you get a look inside Gillette Stadium here in Foxborough. A moment ago, the pride of Massachusetts, the Patriots, introduced to this, as always, sold-out crowd as they get set to go head-to-head with Matthew Stafford and the Detroit Lions. Punter and kickoff man Sam Martin to get us started. And we are underway in Foxborough. This is fielded at the chalk of the 10. And he's up across the 25 and down at the 28-yard line. They'll run for the first time with Sony Michel. And that's not the start that he was looking for, as he's going to be met and dropped behind the line. It'll go as a loss of three right away, and it's second down. So now they have to contend with second and 13 after the first down run goes backwards. Shotgun now for Brady. Here's Sanu on the catch. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. 16 yards, a first down.
I think it all came together there. In-breaking route, drove it with excellent pace. Money throw right there to move the sticks.
Wait, 10, wait, 20.
Watch the run, watch the run.
Right. He's tight right here, he's tight on the right, tight on the right.
We got four.
Wait, 28.
Throwing on first down is Brady. Complete to Watson, the tight end. And they're well past midfield, just a yard or two shy of the 40. 18 big yards on that one, and a New England first down. So the ball moves from their own 41 to the other 41 here for first and 10. Working from the gun, it's Brady. Oh, he can't get away, and Brady will go down. Trey Flowers, the former Arkansas Razorback, in there to get him. And we say it all the time, have to be able to get rid of the ball sooner than that.
You have to help your offensive line out. They're going to protect you as best they can. And if you're getting 3 to 5 seconds to throw the ball, they're doing a really nice job. But when you hold it and give up a sack, you're really almost discrediting their work.
Brady with a hook up to the fellow veteran Watson. And it's going to be another first down as they'll get him to the ground at the Lions 28. This is one thing you can't do with Tom Brady. Let him get in a rhythm. Let him get rolling early.
Every time you talk about Tom Brady or any other great quarterback, you always talk to the defensive guys and they say, you got to get him off his spot. What they mean by that is,
under pressure and down he goes. They sack him back at the 36. Trey Flowers picks up his second sack of the afternoon. Charles, a little bit of feast or famine on this drive. They moved the ball okay, but they've been sacked twice now.
And they've got to figure out how to plug that leak a little bit, right? Keep them away from the quarterback, because when he's not being hit, as you mentioned, they're moving the ball well.
Hey, Foxtrot.
Throwing on second and long. Brady, slant route, caught by Edelman. And he's brought down after a very nice game. It's a gain of 34. Well, how about the passing numbers so far on this first drive?
Well, no doubt about it. They're flinging it around pretty successfully. And look at the start. The confidence level that we see in him rising because he's hit a few early. And how about the last one? The big shot right there.
And they will run it with Michelle. And he is met in his tracks behind the line of scrimmage. It's a loss of a yard there, and now second down. Michelle going to try again. And for a second straight play, the Lion defense drops him behind the line of scrimmage. He'll wind up losing three. And now it's third down. They've been stuffed twice here for losses. Now it's third and goal. They'll try to run it in, Michelle. And he goes backwards on this one, losing yardage to the seven. It's a loss of a full 3 yards, and it brings up fourth down. Mike Nugent now to line up for the field goal. From the left hash, a chip shot here. And the 14-year trusty veteran able to knock it through. Nugent, of course, taking over the kicking duties for Steven Gostkowski in week 5. And Gostkowski, the Pats kicker since 2006. Nugent, also a veteran in the NFL. He's been around since 2005. But Gostkowski, the Pats all-time leader in points and field goals. Yes, even over Adam Vinatieri. Twice an All-Pro. And, of course, 4 times a Super Bowl champion, Gostkowski, as well. But now the reins get turned over to the veteran Mike Nugent. Stafford and the Lions now have it first and 10 at their own 26.
He's checking. Crash.
Now the former Terrapin, this is Ty Johnson. And he's going to get about 7 yards on that one, up to around the 33. On second down now, it's Johnson. It'll be a gain of 3, and it also takes us to the end of the first quarter of play. Pretty good job defensively. Thought he was going to get it, but they knew where that marker was, and they stopped him just short of it.
What it does is emphasize that strategic football and situational football is not just played on the offensive side, is it? Defense understanding, as you noted, where the first down marker was and making sure they didn't get there.
And on third down, a nickel formation here defensively. Now whistles and a flag down. Looked like one of the Lions linemen might have moved. It's Johnson, weaving through traffic, and now he's free. Touchdown, Detroit. Ty Johnson, 69 yards, and the Lions have taken the lead. Well, they were just hoping that run would pick up the first. They got the whole enchilada.
And I'm so used to teams on third down, doesn't matter how far they need for a first down, throwing the ball. Instead, they run it, and as you said, picked up the first down, and then some, in fact, everything, all the way for a touchdown. Terrific play.
The Lions will use the first of their timeouts. They'll have 2 remaining as we step aside here in this second quarter. Now Matt Prater for the point after. And this is up and good to make it 7-3.
Next goal score on line 7, Patriots 3. Sam Martin set to kick off.
So after the touchdown, Martin now on to kick this one away. This is taken at the 3. And he'll take it past the 25 and up to the 28-yard line. New England with a first down as they begin the drive. And they had 3 points last time, but they didn't want 3 points because they were well within range of scoring a touchdown. We'll see if they can do better now.
I'm with you on that one. Let's just go ahead and be frank about the whole thing. The only one happy about the 3 points?
The kicker.
Exactly. You put it through the post, that's going to help him at contract time. But that offense, they're thinking, let's get in the end zone this time.
I don't know if that helped him at contract time. You could have kicked that one through.
I don't know about that.
Toe bash.
I don't know about
toe
that.
Toe bashed it.
Super toe.
The big play to start him out has him at the 45 already.
66. Hey, Haywood. Hey, let's calm down. Hey, let's go. Calm it. Shadow.
From the gun, Brady. That's going to be knocked away and incomplete. The 2017 All-Pro Darius Slay there in coverage, knocking it away.
Nice play there to force the incompletion. And to me, one thing's for sure. When you're the underdogs and you're playing on the road, you absolutely have to get takeaways. You've got to get the ball from them.
Yeah, win that turnover battle, going to be key. They didn't get one there, but you get the feeling they keep making plays like that, they might just get a few.
Yeah, once you get one, defensive teams think they come in bunches.
And it's going to be another first down as they'll get him to the ground at the Lions' 38-yard line.
And he's the epitome of what we call the move tight end, a guy that you can line up anywhere, in the slot, out wide, in tight, doesn't really matter. Because he has such great skills, you want to utilize him in all aspects of your passing offense.
And there he was in the slot for the catch. Had a bit of a lane there, took advantage of it. Give him 7 there on the first down carry. 7 yards on the pickup there, and it'll leave him with a 2nd and 3. On 2nd down, Michelle. He's got a first down and much more inside the 20. That one good for a first down pickup of 18 yards.
At this stage of the game, the run pass numbers are a little bit out of whack because most of their yardage has come through the air. But in a sense, that just sets things up for big runs like that because the defense might be a little bit off balance. They pick up another first down with that run.
On first down, Michelle. And he's going to get about 4 down inside the 10 to the 9. To throw on 2nd and 6, Brady. And this is caught. Touchdown, Patriots. Benjamin Watson. There to make the grab. And once again, the Patriots are back out in front. And he is a reliable target. They like to get him involved. They got him involved there for the score.
And they should. He's a very good player. Remember, they can use him in certain positions, so many different spots, and he usually comes through for them.
Now he's back out there to boom this one away, maybe with some frustration after the PAT miss. This is taken just shy of the 10 here. And he'll take this across the 25, a couple extra yards, up to the 27-yard line. The Lions offense ready to kick off their next drive. And they're hoping to redo their efforts in the last drive when they got into the end zone.
And just think of what it's like now on the sideline. Because when you score a touchdown, you have to go over and look at the tablet and see what you did on the last drive. When you scored points, it's a whole lot better view than when you're trying to figure out how to fix things there.
And he's taken down, but able to slip across the 35. 11 yards there and a Lion first down. They stay on the ground on first for Johnson. And they will only muster a yard here to the 38.
Well, we saw him there trying to get it to the outside, trying to get to the perimeter, but not a whole lot of room there. But there's got to be one positive to that. If you keep moving laterally, creases tend to develop as the game moves on, and they can run it back inside later.
On 2nd and 9, Stafford. Amendola's got it complete. That catch good for only a yard, and it'll be 3rd down.
The goal of a wide receiver screen is get enough blockers in front to create a wall and let him pick his spot to run the football. How about the defense there swarming to it and not allowing that to happen? Did not let him get downfield.
And we've hit the 2-minute mark in this first half of action.
fans, a reminder. I have a note card here that says ad-lib halftime preview. So I guess let's do just that as we'll hand things over to Jonathan Coachman in Orlando when this one reaches halftime. Did I do okay?
You did great. Not a bad job.
Hey.
You know, writing down your ad-lib.
If you print it, I'm going to read it. I'm Brandon Gaudin. Throwing on third down, Stafford. And the throw there going to be incomplete.
You hear the calls for a penalty, but I just don't think so. I think in this situation, the defender was making sure his guy couldn't hold on to the football. So I don't see anything that warranted a flag.
No, I'm with you. There was contact, but I'm happy they kept that flag in the back pocket. And here now the punter, Martin, booming this one away. Officially, that'll be marked down as just a 28-yard punt. And that will come the offense as they take over. The Pats at the line, ready to go. And thus far, the weather has not slowed this offense down one bit. They've looked good so far in the first half.
They certainly have. And think back to our meeting with the head coach. And we asked him because we saw the forecast for this game, didn't we? We said, hey, have you prepared for this? And he talked about the different drills that they've done in adverse conditions, the wet ball drills, things of that nature. He said, I don't think it's going to slow us down much. We tend to handle it pretty well, and he's been right.
Brady's incompletion on first down leads to a second and 10. Brady now to throw. Caught by the tight end, Watson. And he slips up past the 45 before being tackled. 15 yards on the play, first down.
One of the advantages of zone defense, as I remember it, is being able to see the play develop in front of you. One of the disadvantages, when they find those levels where they can hit you with it, sometimes behind the corner and in front of the safety, it makes it tough to defend.
Oh, he can't get away, and Brady will go down. Now the Patriots going to use one of their timeouts as they'll talk things over prior to this upcoming second down play. Sacks, a growing theme in this first half. This is second and long.
51 the mic, 51 the mic. Here we go, here we go.
Rip. Brady. Under pressure again, and down he goes again. Devon Kennard. In there to drop him, and sacks on first and second downs. Now leads to a third and long. Oh, the pressure too great, and he goes down once more. The Lions now going to use the second of their timeouts as they'll stop it with just over 40 seconds to go in the first half. The Patriots send out their punter. Jamal Agnew is deep to return it. He steps into this one, and this is a rocket. Agnew now to return. Officially, that'll be a 63-yard punt. Well done. And the Lions are going to take over with a long field ahead and a first and 10. The Lions offense ready to kick off their next drive. Under a minute to play here in the half. Time for a late drive.
It makes sense when you think about it. Hey, try and get a field goal. Give yourself a lead going into the half. But if you're going to do this, you better have supreme trust in your quarterback. Supreme trust in the guy who's going to handle the football. Because if you turn it over here, not only do you go in down at the half, you've given the momentum squarely to your opponent.
And they're just going to run it here up the middle. That's going to go as a loss of one on first down. Now the Patriots will use the second of their timeouts as they'll stop it with a little over 30 seconds to go in the first half of play. A loss of a yard there to start out. That leads to a second and 11.
Check out.
They'll keep it on the ground again here. And he'll just keep two hands on the football as he'll be taken down after a short pickup. The second down play, not much better than the first, just a gain of one there. Once again, they'll keep it on the ground. And brought down, but not before reaching the 25.
And with just 4 seconds left in this first half, a timeout call. And this will probably be the last play of the quarter. A carry now for McKissick. And he'll get this from the 25 to the 30 for a pickup of 5. Time for a break. We've hit halftime. 2 quarters down. 2 still remain. We step aside. This is the NFL on EA Sports. Forecast calling for more of the same. The rain set to continue as we are underway in the second half. And this will not be returnable. It's out of the back of the end zone for a touchback. The Lions offense ready to kick off their next drive. They trail offense, first time to touch the ball in quarter 3, and we'll see what they can do.
And I can't wait to see what they have planned. Because some teams script to start a half. Other teams just go, okay, these are the sequence of plays we want to run. These things worked well for us. And sometimes they throw in that big chunk play right away.
Shocker.
Try and get after them early and try and create a big play to give themselves some momentum.
See what they have up their sleeve. It's a loss of 2. Now 3rd down.
Michael Bennett's versatility, being able to play any position along the defensive front, allows him to make those types of plays. He finds good matchups and gets into the offensive backfield.
And there it works for a tackle for loss. And that'll be accepted, of course, and that moves him back 5. Delay of game penalty. Ships him back 5 yards. Makes it 3rd and 10. A shotgun snap for Stanford. Looking for Amendola, and it's intercepted. Picked off by Jason McCourty, and he will score. Touchdown, Patriots.
That was an interception, but on the field, the guys who are picking it off, they're not saying that. What word are they using? It's Oski, and that means catch the ball and go the other way.
That's your vernacular. I've never heard anybody say Oski.
Ask around. They'll tell you.
So they'll get another shot on offense following that pick 6. And now the kick is away. And this will be a touchback as that sails over the end line. The Lions offense ready to kick off their next drive. They begin the drive with Johnson. And from the 25, they work this to the 29, a gain of 4. 2nd and 6, just inside the 30. They go to Johnson again. He finds an opening past the 40.
Outside handoff to the right side. If you're a running back, you love getting the ball early so you have vision to see what's happening in front of you.
Right tackle likes that call. Big play for him. But don't forget about the guys you always tell me on the backside sealing off.
When they talk about cutoff blocks, making sure no one can leak from the backside that can run a play down.
Yeah, nobody leaked. Big play. Now a 10th carry for Johnson. And he'll take this one down to about the 40. Just a yard on the pickup there, and it'll bring up a 2nd and 9.
Nice job by that defensive front there to hold him to a short gain on 1st down. Well played, I must say.
Yeah, only getting 1 yard. There was no room to run.
Defense, defense, zebra, You can't block me. You can't block me. You can't block me.
Five, five.
58 to Mike. All day. All day.
58, right over here.
On second and nine, Stafford. He'll get this one to Galladay. And he's taken down, but not before reaching the 10-yard line. A gain there of 30 big ones. Obviously, they're not where they want to be right now on the scoreboard. Big plays like that, though, that'll trend them in the right direction.
Yeah, a few more like that, they'll be right back in the game. And if they can continue to do that, maybe they'll inspire their defense as well to get a few stops.
Stafford on first down. Now he'll escape to his left. Oh, a hit. He lost the football. Stafford puts it on the ground, and it's picked up by the Patriots. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back. And maybe that one caused by the weather. Of course, the rain coming down. Charles, can you maybe, when you're carrying that football, grip it too tight in the rain?
I think that you can, and it's such a delicate balance, too, because when you grip it so tight, sometimes it'll slip out from your body. You squeeze it too hard, and it'll pop out on its own. I've actually had running backs talk to me about that, and when they've tried too hard, even in perfect conditions, the ball gets away from them. They've got to find a good balance, carrying it firmly, yet at the same time under control.
Brady's incompletion on first down leads to a second and 10.
Let's get off the field, D. Let's get off the field, D.
Cover, cover.
To throw again, Brady. And his throw's going to be incomplete. Ben Watson was the intended target, and it's third down.
Let's give some credit to the defensive guys on that play. Able to bat that one away. Sure looked like they were trying to hit the corner route.
So back-to-back incompletions, and that has them staring at a third and 10. From the gun, it's Brady. And now another one thrown incomplete. So it doesn't look like they're going to be able to build off the turnover.
Well, the defense certainly did its part. It got them the football. But you're exactly right. It looks like they're going to have to punt this one away. And it's not a turnover, but doesn't it feel like one after grabbing the momentum with the defensive play?
Yeah, and they had all that momentum after getting the football, and now zapped right back in the other direction. And he gets this away, and look at this. This is a good one. On the return, here's Agnew. A good return there, 17 yards, and the Lions will take over. The Lions offense ready to kick off their next drive. And they'll be looking to atone for last time's mistake of fumbling inside the red zone. Certainly they don't want to do that again.
And so much emphasis placed on red zone.
And he's free going down the left side. It's a foot race. Touchdown, Detroit. Ty Johnson, his second touchdown of the afternoon. As they have now chopped this lead down to three. A good hold in these wet conditions. The point after is up and good, and that will get them one closer. Here's Martin now following the score as he'll send this one away. This is taken at the three. And he'll take it back to about the 19-yard line. New England with a first down as they begin the drive. Certainly want to avoid what they had to do last possession, and that was punt the football, because this game's starting to tighten up.
In a basketball sense, you think about taking a little bit of the air out of the ball, right? Maybe milk some clock, limit the possessions. In this case, they might want to do the same thing, but control the game offensively. Put together some first downs, put together a drive, and keep it away from them.
Well, the first play of the drive lost four. Now they'll look to move it forward here on second and 14. Operating from the gun, Brady. And Watson has it right side. And he'll be taken down, but they've got this one up to the 35-yard line. A gain there of 21 yards. Ball up to the 35 now as they come up on first and 10. From the gun, Brady. He's got a man complete. It's Julian Edelman. This will be stopped about 2 yards shy of the marker. 8-yard gain, second and 2. They'll run it here. This is James White. And he stopped after a gain of one. Not enough. Still a yard to go on third down.
I haven't met a defense coordinator yet that thinks second and two is a fun situation to try and defend. Playbook is wide open for an offense, partner.
Nice job. Hold him to one after that 8-yard pickup on first down. Try to get one more in here before the quarter breaks. And as they come to the line, they will not be able to get off another play as time has run out on this third quarter. This is the National Football League on EA Sports. New England on third down, 0 for 3 to this point. They could use a conversion. They're up against a third and one situation. They'll try and run for it. Here's Michelle, and he will have the first down as he's brought down up near midfield. Third down turns to first with that 5-yard pickup. Keeping it on the ground on first, Michelle. And this carry not as productive. He swallowed up at the line of scrimmage. Trey Flowers there on the tackle. Seems pretty obvious defensively a key was stopping the run game. How have they done it so successfully?
To me, it seems that these guys really did a nice job of paying attention during the scouting report meeting. And you know, Brandon, when they do those, they talk about the top plays that these guys like to run. The best runs for the top running back. Those are the ones you focus on and want to take away, and they've done that pretty successfully in this game.
Throwing on second down, Brady, and his crew will take over at their own 45-yard line.
Okay, partner, no surprise to you. I'm going to look at this from the defensive perspective. In the rain, you have to be more cautious trying to cover passing routes. Why? The offense knows where they're going with the football. The receiver knows the route he's going to run. You have to make sure you keep your footing underneath you.
And they'll start the drive on the ground with Johnson. And he'll be brought down at the 50 after a gain of about 5.
Watch that in. Watch that in.
Again, it's Johnson. And for one of the few times here today, this run's not going to go anywhere. They'll say no gain on the play there, and now it'll be third down. The Lions will use the first of their timeouts. That'll leave them with two remaining. We'll be back after this. The Lions on third down. They've hit 2 for 4 thus far. This will be third and 5.
58, come on. Hey, 50. Pretty quiet. 58, right over there, right over there. Yeah, yeah. Mike, 58, right there.
Hey, Steve 6. Steve 6.
That's got to be a long day.
From the gun, here's Stafford. And he'll find Galladay. That's complete. And he's corralled, but not before getting it inside the 35. He'll get 17 that time, and the Lions have a first down. So they'll come up first and 10 now from the 33.
Switch right to the left, 22.
Stafford going to give this one off to Johnson. And maybe a measure of revenge there. He's had his way in this one, but this time they get him behind the line. They'll keep it on the ground. It's Johnson. The veteran Jason McCourty up to make the tackle. One of the bigger plays in the game thus far. The crowd getting into it as we come up on a big third down. Here's Stafford. And, oh, a crusher there as it's intercepted. Devin McCourty picks it off. And a very good return as he'll take it all the way up to the 40-yard line. Speaking of Devin McCourty and interceptions, he recorded an INT in the Patriots' first four games this year. No one in the league has done that since 2014, and because of that great start to the season, McCourty was named the AFC Defensive Player of the Month for September. Boy, the run on first down, a disaster as he's tackled well behind the line of scrimmage. That'll go as a loss of five, and it'll be a second and long. 2 minutes remain, and that's our score differential as well. 2 points here in the fourth quarter. So the Patriots with a football as we get you reset. And let's see what they've come up with offensively after having time to talk it over. Again, it's Michelle. He finds some open field here. And he'll have it past midfield almost to the 40 before being taken down. That one covers 24 yards. It's a first down. Not totally home free yet, but it's looking good as they come up first and 10. On the ground, Michelle. He's got the first down here inside the 30. That's now a pair of explosive plays in succession, both north of 20 yards.
Well, partner, I have to say they caught him in the right defense there. Nickel set, fifth defensive back on the field, and they love to run against that because now you typically get a bigger blocker on a smaller defender.
Yeah, because those DBs like you, they want the interception. They're not as worried about the running play, right?
Not at all. And I still remember being in school, and one of my offensive line teammates used to say, boy, I'd love to come downfield and hit you little people.
Good run there. I have to imagine this will be on the ground as well as they come up second and 7. Brady gives to Michelle, and he is going to be stopped cold behind the line of scrimmage. The Lions now going to use the second of their timeouts as the clock's going to stop with 47 seconds to go in the fourth. For the Lions, an extra DB in the game now here on third down. Now Brady. Now look at this. They get the turnover they needed. It's intercepted. Picked off inside the 10. You got the slim lead late and the football, so why are you throwing it there?
Remember during the year when we asked one of the head coaches, you know, if you're in this spot, why would you throw the ball? And he talked about trust in his quarterback and trust in his offense.
But still.
And then at the end he kind of went, yeah, not really a good reason.
Right. The Lions offense ready to kick off their next drive. They only need a field goal. Obviously, the clock a huge factor. They'll be watching that. What do they need to do here, Charles?
Your sequence of plays has to get you out of bounds. Completions, get out of bounds, gain some yardage. Then when the clock hits 7 seconds or left, now you've got a decision. Are you in field goal range, or is it Hail Mary time? Because from 7 seconds down, you don't want to take a shot that you're going to have another play.
We'll see how they handle it. And they'll bring him down here up at about the 22-yard line. And the Lions quickly now going to use the last of their timeouts as they get it with just 19 seconds left on the clock. Now on the heels of that run by Johnson, here's another first and 10. They will run it. It's McKissick. 5 yards is the tally on first down. That brings up second and 5. So third and 5, defensively expecting pass. They've got 6 DBs out there. They'll run with McKissick, and he is not going to get the first down as he'll spot this at about the 28. Well, going into the final play of this game, they knew that they needed some type of a miracle.
choppers, that's 20 goons. And them ice cream whip, triple scoop. I got three strikes, ain't got to lose. When it's all on the line, what you gonna do? Come on, I'm highly favored. Don't wanna blame me, no conversation. Ain't got time for no debate. It's for the taking, no hesitation. Don't try my patience. I'ma pour out one for the set, boy, till there's nothing left. On a run to the bread until we all got them baguettes. Hear them footsteps coming, cause we coming for the check. We ain't gon' run, no, we don't hide. I can never switch, not a day in my life. Long as my dogs stay by my side. Yeah, we gon' ride till we die, die, die.
EA Sports coverage of the NFL brings us to the heart of Texas and the very wonderful AT&T Stadium in Arlington. Obviously, they do everything big here in Dallas, and the introduction to the Cowboys, no exception. They're set for football in Big D as their guys will do battle with Tom Brady and the New England Patriots. There's Mike Nugent now to put this one in the air. And we are underway from AT&T Stadium. That's fielded in the end zone. And he'll wind up about 4 yards shy of where he would have. If he'd taken a knee, as they'll start at the 21-yard line.
At their own 21-yard line.
Here we go.
First down, Prescott. It'll hit the slam route. That's caught by Cooper. A good pickup there, a 22.
I don't care who you put on him, he's going to be a handful in one-on-one throws.
Yeah, right now, you're right. They're in man-to-man, maybe need some safety help.
I would say that'd be a good idea. Double team him somehow. I'm going to have to make someone else beat me rather than let him shred my defense.
Here's the first carry for Ezekiel Elliott. And he'll push his way up to about the 44 here. Devin McCourty brings him down.
They tried a quick hitter inside, but that one was swallowed up because what they're hoping, those big defensive linemen will take the bait and move laterally and open up a crease that they can run through. Didn't happen on that play.
On second and nine, Prescott. They'll set up the screen to Elliott. And taking it across midfield and inside the 45. 15 yards on the play, first down.
I like the screen being called here early in the game, especially on the opening drive, because, Brandon, when guys come out of the locker room, especially those pass rushers, they are so amped up to get to the quarterback that you can use that against them, and a screen pass is a great way of doing it. A lot of teams against good pass rushing teams, they want to run the screen 10 to 12 times in a game.
Now, meanwhile, a pass that should have been intercepted, but it winds up falling incomplete. Ball on the 42 as they come up second and 10. Throwing, Prescott. He'll buy some time right. And he's going to be down at the 35. Gain of 7.
That's a gain of 7. Brings him third and 3.
Mike, 58 right there.
They just get the playoff. Now Prescott. And he's able to hook up with Michael Gallup. And he's got another first down as the tackle's going to be made at the Patriots 23. Nice job keeping that opening drive alive, and they're in plus territory, that part of the field where you really want to convert on third down. They did.
Big time pickup for them, and now I think the aggressive play callers think to themselves, this part of the field, I take my shot at the end zone, because the closer you get to the end zone, the field gets condensed. Makes it a lot tougher to run those routes. You still got a chance to actually run past people right now. Take your shot at the end zone early in the down and distance count.
Maybe just a slight detour on what's been a strong drive. Here's second and 11. Looking for Cooper, and it's intercepted. Picked off by Jason McCourty. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back. Cooper was the intended target. Brady and the Patriots now first and 10 at their own 12-yard line. So after the INT, it's Brady. The tank, DeMarcus Lawrence with a sack.
Didn't have the greatest field position to start, did they? And now after this sack, it's way, way worse.
And right off the bat, first play of the game. Now following the sack, they'll look to make amends on a second down and 17. Now Brady, looking for Edelman, and he hits him. It's complete. The reception good for seven. It's third down. Throwing is Brady on third down, and that is incomplete. So the defense able to get off the field here on third down.
And it's one of the goals of the game. They've got to be effective on passing downs. It's one of the few things defenses chart. How did we do on third down? That's a nice start for them in this one.
On is the punt team now as this one's sent away. Now Austin. And past the 40 before he's out of bounds. So possession goes over here on the punt. And the Cowboys will take over the football with a first and 10. About set for this next drive by the Cowboys offense. Well, they were intercepted the first time they had the football, but now they get it back, and it's still 0-0.
And because of that, you know what the thought process is? Interception. What interception? It didn't really happen because they gave up no points. So go back on the attack. Go back and run the offense you believe will be successful. Find your playmakers and give them the football.
From midfield now on second down, Prescott. He almost had it. The big D lineman nearly had an interception. Instead, it falls down incomplete. After the incompletion, here now, third and two. Prescott now from the 50. Flush to his right. And he can't find anywhere to go with it, and he goes down. Kyle Van Noy able to get him down for a loss of 11, and it brings up fourth down. So on fourth down, here's Chris Jones to punt it away. And it's out of bounds. Now we'll see what the side judge says. He says out at the 8-yard line. So they'll play the field position game here as a very nice punt is going to pin them back.
Yeah, it's almost like watching a game of tennis, or do you prefer ping pong, you know, back and forth like that? But it definitely was excellent, wasn't it?
The Pats at the line ready to go. They're going to have to go at least 50, 60 yards here if they want to ensure that they don't have to punt the ball like they did last time.
Yeah, so what you're saying is we're not playing to just get out of the shadow of your own goal line, right? You're playing to make sure the punter doesn't see the field again. So it's not picking up a couple of first downs. You want to pick up five or six first downs and make sure you move the ball into their territory.
He's going to wind up and air it out. Well, this is taken in. It's complete. Past the 20. And all the way in. Touchdown, New England. Mohamed Sanu, 92 yards. As his guys are able to strike first here in this opening quarter. So from back deep, deep in their home territory, all the way into the end zone. Do you think they expected to score on that one?
I'm not sure they expected to score, but they also show that they're not averse to taking a little bit of a risk there, right? Taking a chance, because the normal call is take care of the football, run
it, be safe.
Be safe. Instead, they put it in the air and took a gamble, and it paid off in a big way. That wasn't an analytics call. That wasn't a fantasy guy's call. That was like a video game call right there.
It was a little bit of a video game call, but it worked. The Dallas offense here set to begin the drive, and the results for them have not been strong to this point. Two drives have ended in a turnover and then a punt.
So would it be too snarky for me to say that they've shown improvement? Because you had two drives with turnovers. Now they punted it away, so at least they didn't turn it over. That's good, right?
You're going to get some angry users reaching out to you on social media.
Well, I don't mean to be. I was actually looking for the positive. Silver lining, you know.
And this should be the final play before the quarter ends. A second down throw for Prescott. And this is caught by Witten, the tight end. And he'll be taken down, as that will take us to the end of the first quarter of play. 6-0 our score after one. A first down carry by Elliott. And he'll work it across midfield inside the 45. 17 yards on the play there, and the Cowboys have a first down.
I think they like this drive a little bit better there, partner. Running game helping out, picking up some of the slack. Because remember, last drive, they went 3 and out.
This offense finding its legs now. Here's another 1st and 10. Here's Prescott, eluding the pressure right. And they're not able to hook up there. Incomplete.
I know our vantage point might be a little bit better way up here, but that looked like an ill-advised throw to me. I didn't see anything open, and this play just didn't look right from the beginning.
It did not. I thought he might get outside and just chuck it away. Dangerous pass, incomplete. So 2nd down, still 10 yards to go. Ball on the 43. Prescott to throw it. He's going to find Gallup here, complete. And he's got another 1st down as the tackle's going to be made at the Patriots 28.
That was a nicely run slant route, and what the receiver's trying to do is make the defender think he's going upfield for a deeper route and then breaks it off, usually after about 3 to 4 steps, and cuts towards the middle of the field. And now what he's trying to do is use his body to keep the defender away from the football and give the quarterback a really nice target.
And they'll bring him down at the 18-yard line. 10 yards on the pickup there, and it'll be 2nd down.
10 yards on the pickup. It's 2nd and inches at the 18-yard line.
Still a few inches short of a 1st down as they come up now on 2nd down. And again, it's Prescott escaping the pressure right. And that will be caught, but out of the end zone, says the field judge. It's ruled incomplete. The Cowboys' all-time receptions leader, Jason Witten, the intended target. 3rd down here.
58. Here we go. Here we go. Here we go.
They'll throw again. Prescott. He rifles one that's intercepted. Picked off by Jason McCourty. And the return here will go to the 31-yard line.
Brandon, this is why golfers do their best to never count a score in their head before the ball goes in the cup. This looked like a slam dunk for points on this drive, didn't it? Instead, they throw an interception, and they're going to come away empty.
Line of scrimmage, the 31 now on 1st and 10. Here's Brady to throw. Complete to Watson, the tight end. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. That'll be a New England 1st down, a gain of 12. Brady now on 1st down. Slant route, caught by Edelman. A good gain again. That's now 31 yards combined on those last two plays. And finding Edelman underneath, that's a recipe for success.
Typical route for a good slot receiver, and Edelman's one of the best in the game.
Knows how to go inside what one of my college coaches used to call the briar patch. Got to go in there where it's tough and make those tough catches. And not only can he do it, he can often run away from people after the catch.
Give him three on the play, and it'll make it a second down. At the 34-yard line. That first down completion only netted him three. Second and seven.
He's getting me. He's not going to get me. Mike 54. Mike 54.
Again, they'll throw with Brady. Caught by Sanu. And he gets this one inside the 15, just a yard or two shy of the 10. It's a gain of 22 as we tick towards the two-minute warning. On first and 10, here's Brady. Has a man, and it's Edelman for the Patriot touchdown. Julian Edelman there to make the grab. And the Patriots, they add on to their lead. And he's a little bit on the shorter side as a receiver. Maybe sometimes for the defense, tough to find the little guys, right?
Yeah, sometimes they get lost in the traffic. But usually what it means is that rather than just winning with height or even speed, they use their quickness to find a way to get open.
Well, tall, short, wide, skinny, whatever. There it results in a touchdown. This is fielded at the goal line. And not a bad return. Here he gets it out to the 25-yard line. About set for this next drive by the Cowboys offense. And two interceptions thrown here in this first half. You hear it, no matter the sport, they say the great. The Pats are going to get there. Down he goes. Kyle Van Noy able to get in there for his second sack of the afternoon. 2 minutes remaining in this first half of football. After the sack, it's second and 19, and the road gets a bit tougher from here. A reminder that when halftime rolls around, Jonathan Coachman will have all the highlights and analysis of this first half of play from our studios in Orlando. That one good for 17 as they're set up better now for third down. And how about the call here? They need 2 yards in their own territory on fourth down, and they're going to go for it. They'll run it with Elliott, and he will have a first down here at about the 40. A curious decision to go for it, but it pays off with a first down. Oh, on the defensive side, that is so deflating.
Not only is it deflating, they've got to look at each other's eyes on that side of the ball and take each other's measure. You got him backed up.
Nowhere to escape, and he goes down. Kyle Van Noy giving him once again his third sack of the afternoon.
I'm starting to feel for that quarterback back there. I mean, you know me. Normally, don't have a lot of empathy for the QB, right? In this case, definitely he's been on constant duress this entire game. I don't know how he's surviving back there.
And to think, there's still a long way to go in this football game. Now, meanwhile, here's a second down throw that's knocked away and incomplete. An incomplete pass on that last play, and that means they'll need to come up with something here on third down. Prescott from the gun. And that will be incomplete. You can tell they were hoping for a flag there offensively. Several on the sideline motioning. Hey, why not a penalty? Why not a penalty? What did you see?
Yeah, I think you've got to let them play. And the officials are instructed, if there's contact coming from both sides, no flag. Let them fight it out.
And forces fourth down. And how about this? Fourth and long, and they're going to go for it. So a jump there defensively.
And it's a killer. Watch the football. Don't move across the line of scrimmage until the ball moves.
Dak and the offense still out there. They are going to go for it.
48, right over there, right over there. Yeah, yeah. Mike,
47.
Here we go.
They're indeed going for it. It's Prescott. Complete to Jason Witten. Not often do fourth down conversions result in 23 yards, but that's the case here. First down.
Every play is supposed to get a player's best effort. But on fourth down, that really increases the stakes, doesn't it? What about that catch?
Heck of an effort picking up the first.
And now that team has to be motivated going forward.
And for the third time here in this half, it's intercepted. Picked off by Stephon Gilmore. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back.
So that's back-to-back drives where they've thrown an interception. Ordinarily, we look at the offense and say, what's going on with your scheme? Maybe we should look at the defense and just give them a whole lot of credit. They've got them frustrated right now.
The Pats at the line, ready to go. You've got under a minute to go here until halftime. You've got the good size lead. No need to do anything crazy.
No, there really is no need to do anything crazy. The smart play, go ahead and take your lead into the locker room and then try and add to it in the second half. But there's a part of me that looks at this and says,
Philip Dorsett by himself and all the way in. Touchdown, New England. Tom Brady, his third touchdown pass of this first half. And the Patriots, they add on to their lead.
I heard a coach talk about those late in the half scores, especially ones that give your team a pretty decent cushion. He said those could be the ones that could finish off a squad if you let them.
Yeah, they've got the cushion. This half has been theirs. After the touchdown, here's Mike Nugent now to kick this one away. This is fielded at the goal line. And he's up across the 25 and down at the 28-yard line. The Dallas offense here set to begin the drive. We're under 20 seconds to go in the half. I'm guessing the wise play here is be safe.
That is the wise play because if you think about trying to fool...
And his pass is intercepted for the fourth time today. Devin McCourty picks it off. And his guys have got it back at the closing stages of the first half. Cooper was the target there. So first and 10 now from the 30. Working from the gun, it's Brady. Caught by the tight end, Watson. And he'll take it into the end zone for a Patriot touchdown. Benjamin Watson in the final seconds of the first half. And the Patriots, they add on to their lead. Nugent on now for the extra point. And that stretches the lead to 27.
Mexico score, Patriots 27. Cowboys 7.
After the touchdown, here's Mike Nugent now to kick this one away. This is fielded at the goal line. First half in the books. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports. And we welcome you back live now inside the booth alongside Charles Davis. I'm Brandon Gordon, set and ready to rock for the third quarter. So here we go for half number two. The Patriots with the lead, and they will be getting the football. That'll be taken in the end zone. And he will be brought down here at about the 17-yard line. The Pats at the line, ready to go. They built a good first half lead. Now they have a chance to add on to it.
And what I'm thinking is that the offensive staff spent the entire halftime just working with them on Here's what we think they're going to do to attack us in this.
He's got a man complete. And all the way down to the 26. A big play there for New England. 57 yards.
I've got to make sure that I don't take Tom Brady's greatness for granted, that we make it routine. How about that throw right there? Yeah. Another great completion.
And you know one area where he honed his throwing? He was a catcher in high school. He was actually drafted by the Expos in 1995 in the 18th round.
Wow, that would have been something to see him behind the dish.
I think he gunned down a few guys.
Gunned down a few guys trying to steal second. That would have been fun to watch.
Once again, they'll come up on the 26-yard line, second and 10.
Go, go, go.
Throwing again, Brady, and now a fumble. Brady loses the football.
On plays like this, where the ball comes free, it's often unusual for the team that lost it to get it back, because this is the quarterback. The ball gets away from him. Everyone else is trying to execute what they're supposed to do on offense. They're usually looking in the other direction, downfield, or have moved away from him. In this case, though, a teammate is able to come up with the ball.
On third and long, it's Brady. And he's going to go down again. DeMarcus Lawrence picks up his second sack of the afternoon. Brady to throw for it on fourth down. And the pressure gets to him again. DeMarcus Lawrence. And the Cowboys defense is going to get him the football back. So they'll trudge off the field with a bitter taste in their mouths after that failed fourth down conversion.
Yeah, there'll be a lot of analysis there on the sidelines. Was it the right call? Was it against the right defense? Should they have even gone for it at all? Will that change what they do going forward in this game? A lot of questions to be answered by them. The defense doesn't really care. They're like, bring it on again. We'll stop you the next time, too.
Now here's a pass on first down that's knocked away and incomplete. Amari Cooper, the intended target. And that'll bring up second down.
Here we go. Four and in. 54 is Mike. Check, check. Watch 54. Watch 54. Here we go. Here we go. 26.
Prescott. And that is incomplete here. The veteran Stephon Gilmore able to break that one up.
And we just saw another example. These cornerbacks have played tight coverage all game long. Might start wanting to think about a few double, triple move routes to try and shake their guys free.
They have, you're right, they have had no room to breathe.
And now the third down throw incomplete as well. The veteran Jason McCourty there to make sure that one didn't find its target.
It was no secret who they were trying to get the football to.
Well, no, they went to him on first down, second down, third down, all three incomplete.
Yeah, and when you're unable to connect and you force it in that direction, all you're doing is giving confidence to the defense. They feel like they're really hurting you in a big way.
On fourth, they do snap it to Prescott. But he's able to hook up with Michael Gallup. And he'll work it across midfield inside the 45. Give him 18 on that one, and it's a Dallas first down.
Mike 54.
Hey, watch the slant.
A first down throw for Prescott. Dancing to his left. And this will be incomplete.
Yeah, that one sailed on him. You've got to make sure you give your receiver a chance to come down inbounds, because they are very gifted. They'll make the circus catches, but if they make them out of bounds, that does you no good.
So now second and 10 after the incompletion on first down. They play fake to Elliott. Now Prescott. And that going to be incomplete. A lot of contact, no call, and it's third down. We saw this a lot in the first half, and it continues. These receivers just not able to get much separation.
So that means they have to win the 50-50 balls. They've got to go up with the defender and find a way to start coming down with them.
And this time, contact and another
And now here is another interception. picked off by Dante Hightower. And they have possession, and they have it at the 38-yard line. The Pats at the line, ready to go. They had a great drive going last time. They were moving the ball, and then all of a sudden it just stalled out. So we'll see what they can do here, Charles.
And it's always easy to second guess when you don't get it on a fourth down try. But they had to like the feeling that they had going on offense. They want to continue to see if they can capture that again on this drive and maybe get in the same position.
Yeah, and that's, I mean, like I said, they were moving the football. It's not like they went four and out, so I don't think it's a deal where the offense doesn't have confidence.
No, I agree with you totally on that one. If anything, they may have gained more confidence. Okay, they stopped us once. That's all right. Let's keep moving it. Make them do it again.
Looking to throw again on second down. Brady. He's got Lacoste, his tight end. And taking it across midfield and inside the 45. A gain of 13. It's a first down. And passing yardage-wise, now up over 350 in this game. Pretty nice performance.
Definitely that, which usually means you're putting a lot of pressure on guys trying to cover. If you're a defensive back and they put over 350 yards on you, you've had a long day. The key to everything, if you're doing it without throwing interceptions or turning the ball over.
Brady's incompletion on first down leads to a second and 10. To throw again, Brady, and that'll be incomplete. Took a pretty good shot as he tried to pull that one in. Couldn't hang on, third down.
And now offensively it's third and 10, and I'm just thinking to myself, actors always say, what's my motivation before a big scene? Right now the play caller's thinking, what have I done before that's worked well that I can go to right now?
Yeah, because they were pretty successful in the first half scoring points. Haven't done anything so far here in the second half.
It'll be a gain of 8, but it'll also lead to a fourth down.
Whether you're playing West Coast offense or not, one of the maxims of the West Coast offense is you're either throwing a touchdown or a check down. In other words, look for the big shot, but be smart. I think they did exactly that on that play. They didn't get the first down, but they're taking care of the ball well.
Yeah, and being rightly cautious with that lead here in the second half. And he is not going anywhere. They stop him for no gain. Sony Michel won't get there. And the Cowboys defense is going to get him the football back. About set for this next drive by the Cowboys offense. They are right now just ice cold. I mean, they have struggled big time in this game, and they're getting blown out. How do they adjust?
So tough, because we always talk about it being a team game, and you need all 11 working well together. But every now and then, partner, you need that one guy who can make a play against all odds that maybe can ignite things. And I think that's what they're looking for right now.
Yeah, you talk about going to your playmakers. They probably need to do it.
Find someone that you're used to touching the football that makes big plays and give them that opportunity to maybe wake up everyone else. I'm trying to decipher what's going on out there, because I don't know if he's just getting bad reads. I don't know if the defense is confusing him. I don't know if he just has, you know, bad info and intel before he snaps the ball, but he's made some pretty bad decisions with the football lately.
Yeah, several bad decisions on the interceptions he's thrown, and frankly, that should have been another pick right there. So after the second down incompletion, they'll come up now against a third and 6. Now Prescott. Buying time to his, and he's going to have to eat this one as down he goes. Kyle Van Noy, who else? He's in there for his fourth sack of the afternoon.
It's been a tough one all game long for this offensive line. They're already down big, and now you know they're just going to come after the quarterback in a big way, don't you?
Yeah, they just can't get out of their own way right now. It's created an avalanche, and an avalanche is coming right on top of them. I guess they figure they got to start taking some chances. Here's a big one in this third quarter as he'll go for it on fourth down. Looking deep for Elliott. And my goodness, another interception. Picked off by Daron Harmon. And his guys are going to have the football back as the third quarter comes to an end. Back now in Arlington. A lot of folks starting to make their way to the parking lot. Their guys trail big here to begin quarter number 4. So Brady and the Pats take over first and 10 at their 25-yard line. 48. So after the INT, it's Brady. Wide open receiver complete.
And he'll be taken down, but not before they work it across midfield. That'll wind up a gain of 27 on the catch and run.
And the game just keeps evolving. Big guys running those corner routes, so difficult to cover.
Brady now, a perfect 8 for 8 to start the second half. Not bad. First and 10. Brady now to throw. He hits his target. Left side, Watson. And he's going to get this down near the 30-yard line. 18 big yards on that one. And a New England first down. They have the nice cushion. They just want to pour it on right now, still throwing the football.
And I know my background says, why do you need to do this? Just go ahead and run out the clock and get a win. But as many people have pointed out to me, this is a video game, man. Go ahead and put the numbers up. Sportsmanship, not an issue.
Exercise those fingers. Throwing on first down is Brady. Toward the center of the field, but it's incomplete. The incompletion there stops the clock. Any surprise or throwing here late?
Ordinarily, yes, because you would think enough is enough. They've got plenty of lead, but I've seen this a bunch of times as well. The defense is going to crowd the line of scrimmage. If you just hand it off inside, you're getting your running back popped a lot as well. Sometimes the defense dictates it. If they're going to crowd it, you may have no other choice but to throw it downfield.
Looking back to the air on second down, it's Brady. He's going to air one out. Dorsett's got it. Touchdown, Patriots. 5 touchdown passes now for Tom Brady as his guys continue to put this one out of reach.
And now we've hit that stage of the game, partner, where one of our predecessors, one of the great commentators of all time, he's to sing in this situation when this game appeared to be over.
I know the fat lady's been singing for some time.
No, not her at all. This
but
one of our guys.
She's singing too.
Oh, she's singing. She's at least
on like the fifth tune
this point. She left scales way behind. But he's to sing something about turning out the lights. The party was over.
Extra point coming now for Nugent. Now this one was over a while ago as they just add on to their big lead. And after the touchdown, here's Mike Nugent now to kick this one away. This fielded a few yards into the end zone. And this return nets positive as he gets past the 25 and up to the 27-yard line. The Dallas offense here set to begin the drive. And let's face it, this drive is not going to have any bearing on this game, but it's kind of important for one reason, isn't it?
It certainly is. You got to get points. And okay, all right, I'm being facetious here. But you get points, you feel a little bit better about yourself as you move on to the next one.
17 yards on the play there, and the Cowboys have a first down. I tell you, they didn't give it to him much for the first three quarters, but when they have, he's been efficient. Maybe they ride him more here down the stretch.
Yeah, I'm not sure it was actually in the game plan for him to have as few carries as he has, but it might play out really well for them now. As you noted, they want to ride him down the stretch. He should have fresh legs.
On second and 7, Prescott completes it to Jason Witten. And he's got another first down as the tackle's going to be made at the Patriots' 44-yard line.
Nice game there, partner, but you and I both know that won't do anything for the final score. They're not going to win this one. Right now they're playing for pride and fantasy points.
And just to erase that goose egg, nobody wants to be shut out. Elliott, absolutely nobody fooled there. He's going nowhere fast as he stopped behind the line of scrimmage. Throwing on second and 14. Prescott, they'll set up the screen to Elliott. And they go backwards here, losing yardage back at the 48-yard line. And now they're looking for 19 yards here on third down following two negative plays. Prescott down. Cooper's got him. And he goes down, but not before getting this inside the 25. A big 30-yard play on third. Just 2 minutes remaining here in the fourth quarter of what has been a one-sided affair. So the Cowboys in possession of the football here as we get you reset. They've got a first and 10 as they search for a late score. Now a play fake here on first down. And that's incomplete. Just nothing there again. He's been sacked multiple times. We've seen the interceptions, of course. He's really been through the ringer, hasn't he?
And what we've seen is a defense that's well coordinated. The front and the back really in sync. The front putting on the pressure. The backside being ball hawks and picking passes off.
Once again, they'll go from the 23-yard line on second and 10.
Why? Get wide.
Mike's 5-4.
Now Elliott, and an alley to run. And he's going to get this one down inside the 15. 9 yards on the pickup there as he'll be left with third and one. This will be play number 8 here on the drive. It's third and a yard. They go to Elliott again. And they corral him just a couple yards shy of the end zone. They're able to convert on third down, and that sets up a first and goal.
Well, partner, I know this type of running back. I mean, this size, this intensity usually gets better as the game goes on. And I can just tell you from experience, the first few quarters, oh, you're eager. You come running up there. I'm going to tackle this guy. By the fourth quarter, you're coming up and thinking about it.
And D-line wearing down fourth quarter. And somewhat of a measure of revenge as he's in for the touchdown, but they still trail big time.
He'll take it, but he won't be able to smile about it.
So they will get on the scoreboard here. Give him credit for that. Too little, too late, but no zero. Are you? You're going slow clap on me.
Not very nice, is it?
No, but they haven't been very nice on offense. It's been a struggle. Brett Maher on for the extra point. And the lead drops from 34 to 27. So it would no doubt be a miracle comeback from here, but let's see what they can do starting with the onside kick. And this is secured by the Patriots. So they touched it before it went 10, and that's obviously not going to help their comeback bid here in the fourth.
No, not at all. And they're trying to get something going after one there. But you've got to give yourself a chance. Let it go 10 before you touch it.
Wait, set.
Alabama. 380.
Let's go, D. Tighten up. Let's go, D. Tighten up.
450.
On the toss, here's Michelle. And this one goes nowhere. Losing yardage on the play back at the 46. That's going to go as a loss of 7, and it'll set him back for second down.
Hey, keep it up.
Brady going to look to throw. Sliding out of the pocket. Oh, you saw that one coming. It's intercepted. Throwing back across his body. He's picked off just shy of midfield.
Well, I get what he was trying to do. He was moving to his right and trying to shift the coverage, but instead he shifted the coverage also to the right and threw right into it for an interception.
About set for this next drive by the Cowboys offense. They've lost this one. Their offense has struggled. Do they try to put together something here at the end just to take into next week?
Yeah, sometimes teams want to do that and coaches want to. I remember one time I was on a team and we were losing late in a game like this and you knew it was lost. It was over, right? And a coach called a running play.
Ezekiel Elliott gonna take it the distance. Touchdown, Cowboys! Ezekiel Elliott, his second touchdown of the afternoon. And the Cowboys get a bit closer.
And yeah, that touchdown counts for their team. But I think it counts more for the fantasy guys, doesn't it?
Yeah, it's just something maybe positive to look at on film. But this one's over, let's be honest.
Yeah, I agree with you totally on that one.
Extra point by Marr, up and good. And the lead now down to 20. The Pats at the line, ready to go. And three timeouts remaining here defensively, but really not much reason to use them at this point as this one is all but over.
If they use the timeouts here, it's strictly for show. We got a plane to catch.
Meanwhile, they take a shot to start the drive, but this is going to wind up incomplete. Edelman, the intended receiver that time, and that'll bring up second down. Brady going to throw here. Nowhere to escape, and he goes down. So this will wind up a victory for the New England Patriots. And I'll tell you what, it has not been with a whole lot of frequency over the last couple of decades or so that teams have come into New England and escaped with a victory, but that's what happened here.
It almost doesn't feel real, does it?
We've seen it so few times.
That actually happened, right? We saw it. They came out of there with a win. And on the other side, in that locker room, you know what they're saying? We didn't really lose. Time just ran out on us. That's the attitude they have because they don't see it happen very often, not even sure how to handle it.
And you see some stunned faces heading for the exits here in New England. So that'll do it. For my partner, Charles Davis, and the best darn crew in the industry, I'm Brandon Gaughton. This has been a presentation of the NFL on EA Sports. With that, we say so long.